Friends in Christ, it's the fourth Sunday of Ordinary Time, 31st January 2021, and it also happens to be the last day of January. God has brought us here, and we need to bless God. I've given you a homily, it's about 30 minutes long, but I want to summarize the gospel with you. Mark chapter 1, verse 21 to 28. Jesus comes to Capernaum, and on the Sabbath he enters the synagogue, and he taught. His teaching makes a deep impression on the people, and they were surprised. They were astonished and say, he speaks with authority, not like the scribes. In their synagogue, there was a man with an unclean spirit. He cried out, what have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God. Jesus rebuked him and said, quiet, come out of him. Then the spirit came, convulsed him and came out of him. Then they were astonished. This is a new teaching. He commands the unclean spirit, they come out of him. Then his fame spread through everywhere. I've run through the gospel because I want to make this homily, this message very brief. Am I the unclean spirit myself? Aren't you the unclean spirit yourself? Jesus comes to the synagogue and there's a man with unclean spirit. His name is not given. He asks Jesus, have you come to destroy us? Jesus does not go to the cemetery. Jesus does not go to the river. Jesus did not go to the mountains. Jesus did not go to the sepulchres, the tombs, where evil spirits abide. Mark 5 verse 1, the Gospel of Mark chapter 5 verse 1. We are told that the evil spirits had the tombs and sepulchres as the place of their abode. Today in parts of Africa, yes, some mountains, some rivers are places where these spirits abide. But how can an evil spirit come to abide in the synagogue where God's word was proclaimed and shared? The question is, yes, I've explained the gospel to you, but as I was ended it, I want to share this brief with you, this brief message. Aren't you the impure spirit yourself? How? When I become impediment of my own liberation, when I come before Christ at church, a program, and I'm not able to receive the impact of the word, I become an unclean spirit to myself. How? Because of the things I'm listening. The things I'm listening which are making my ears dull from the true message of Christ. The things I'm reading, they are blinding my eyes from the true message of Christ. The things I'm consuming that are blocking my stomach from receiving the word of God, which is given as bread of life. There are places I'm walking to that are drawing me away from God, so I can't present myself before Christ. In these ways, beloved, you and I could become the unclean spirit, the impure spirit, and not any man or woman who brings it to church. Let's reflect on these words. Am I the person who is impeding my own liberation, my own advancement? Am I retrogressing because of my own ways, things I am reading, things I'm listening to, things I am eating, people I'm associating with? I pray the sanctity of Christ liberates you. I pray the power of his word that shut up this evil spirit may open yourself, may open your life to him. Beloved, ask Christ that his word that comes to you this day will free you up, will open you up. There are many great and holy things, precious things to receive, to benefit once you open up. May Christ make this available to you as you open up to him. God loves you. Stay blessed. Amen.